الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي خلق السماوات والأرض وجعل الظلمات والنور ثم الذين كفروا بربهم يعدلون الحمد لله الذي جعل الليل والنهار خلفة لمن أراد أن يذكر أو أراد شكورا ووفق من شاء من عباده لعمارتها المتنوعة ليزدادوا إيمانا مع إيمانهم وأولئك كان سعيهم مشكورا وخذل من أعرض عن ذكر ربه واتبع هواه وأولئك مأواهم جهنم وساءت مصيرا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له إله الأولين والآخرين وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد فاتقوا الله عباد الله واعلموا أن من اتقى الله وقاه ومن أقرضه جزاه ومن شكره زاده يقول رب العزة جل في علاه يا أيها الذين آمنوا إن تتقوا الله يجعل لكم فرقانا ويكفر عنكم سيئاتكم ويغفر لكم والله ذو الفضل العظيم. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, today I'd like to remind myself and you brothers about the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, كتاب الله عز وجل, the book of life for the believers. Our beloved Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in authentic hadith, which is muttafaq alayhi, is recorded both Bukhari and Muslim and many other scholars of hadith, he said, ما من نبي إلا أعطاه الله ما من نبي من الأنبياء إلا أعطاه الله من الآيات ما مثله آمن عليه البشر. There is no a single messenger, there isn't a single prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to him miracles because of it which people have believed. وَإِنَّمَا كَانَ الَّذِي أُوتِيتُ وَحْيًا أَوْحَاهُ اللَّهُ إِلَيَّ. And the miracle that I've been given, it's a divine inspiration from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he revealed unto me. When we look into this beautiful hadith, brothers and sisters in Islam, first of all, we realize that there isn't a single nation on this earth except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent from among them a messenger and prophet. And there's many ayat which support this issue. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Fatir, ayah 24, وَيَمِنْ أُمَّةٍ إِلَّا خَلَى فِيهَا نَذِيرٌ. There's no ummah, there's no nation except there was among them nadir, a warner. And in Surah Al-Ra'd, ayah number 7, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلِكُلِّ قَوْمٍ هَاد. For every nation there was a guide, head. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also said in Surah Al-Nahl, ayah 36, وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ رَسُولًا. So there isn't a single nation on this earth except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent from among them a messenger. Why? Because it's so important that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He created mankind, the only purpose behind their creation was just to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Then how can this take place when there is no honor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? In that way, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not send a messenger from among us, so we have objections. We could object, we could claim that no one came to remind us of you, Allah. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is cutting this off. And this is the wisdom behind, the hikmah behind sending prophets and messengers from among us. There are so many ayat in the Quran which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also indicated in this aspect. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah An-Nisa, ayah 165, رُسُلًا مُبَشِّرِينَ وَمُنذِرِينَ لِأَلَّا يَكُونَ لِلنَّاسِ عَلَى اللَّهِ حُجَّةٌ بَعْدَ الرُّسُلِ. Anbiya and messengers who are warners and came to give good news, glad tidings, so that mankind have no plea, no objections against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the day of judgment, ikhwani, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He sends messengers from among us, those who follow their footsteps, then in the day of judgment, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَرِيقٌ فِي الْجَنَّةِ وَفَرِيقٌ فِي السَّعِيرِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as He said so many ayahs in the Quran, وَمَا رَبُّكَ بِظَلَّامٍ لِلْعَبِيدِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَظْلِمُ النَّاسَ شَيْئًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not do any wrong to His slaves. وَمَا كُنَّا مُعَذِّبِينَ حَتَّى نَبْعَثَ رَسُولًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, we will never punish until we send a messenger from among people. Also in Surah Al-Taha,
آية 134 الله سبحانه وتعالى said ولو أن أهلكناهم بعذاب من قبله لقالوا ربنا لولا أرسلت إلينا رسولا فنتبع آياتك ونكون من المؤمنين. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is cutting this justification is off. So we have no say in the day of judgment when our messengers come from among us. ما من الأنبياء نبي إلا أعطي ما مثله آمن عليه البشر. So every prophet, every messenger, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him signs. I said gave him because there was no messenger from among women. وما أرسلنا قبلك إلا رجالا. It's clear in the Quran. إلا رجالا نوحي إليهم. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He sent mankind, a messenger from among them, He sent men from among them. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whenever He sends one from among us, He gives him a sign, a miracle. Because of that, with people we believe. And so, among so many miracles that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed among our, upon our beloved messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is Qur'an. Al-mu'jiz al-khalida. This is everlasting miracles, brother, a miracle, brothers and sisters in Islam. Quran is the everlasting miracle. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَكَذَلِكَ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ رُوحًا مِنْ أَمْرِنَا مَا كُنْتَ تَدْرِي مَا الْكِتَابُ وَلَا الْإِيمَانِ. In Surah Ash-Shura, Ayah 52. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said that, this we reveal the Quran unto you. But before this message came to you, you knew nothing about Quran or faith. So is indeed the Quran is indeed from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's clearly from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Naml, Ayah number 6, وَإِنَّكَ لَتُلَقَّى الْقُرْآنَ مِنْ لَدُّ حَكِيمٍ عَلِيمٍ. Indeed, you surely receive the message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the all-wise and the all-knowing. So the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is clear. The Quran is a message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, brothers and sisters. It's the everlasting miracle of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you look at the Quran, brothers and sisters in Islam, when Allah revealed at the time, the Quraysh neglected it. They said, وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا إِنْ هَذَا إِلَّا إِفْكٌ افْتَرَاهُ. في سورة الفرقان آية number 4. إِنْ هَذَا إِلَّا إِفْكٌ افْتَرَاهُ وَأَعَانَهُ عَلَيْهِ قَوْمٌ آخَرُونَ. They said, this is just nothing but lie. Muhammad is lying, he's fabricating, he's a lies. It's not a Quran. Not only that, they said he did it with the help of others. To the extent where when they said in Surah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala حَاكِيًا عَنْهُمْ فِي Surah Al-Anfal Ayah 30, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said وَإِذَا تُتْلَى عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُنَا, when our Quran, our verses, our ayat being recited to them, قَالُوا قَدْ سَمِعْنَا, they said we have heard, لَوْ نَشَاءُ لَقُلْنَا مِثْلَ هَذَا, we see this message, and if you want to say something like this, we could have said it. We could have produced something like this Quran. We could have fabricated it. In هذا إلا أساطير الأولين. It's nothing but the fables of ancients. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clearly told us, brothers and sisters, this message is the most beautiful message. There's no lie into it. And no one on this earth could ever produce such Quran like this, brothers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, الله نزل أحسن الحديث كتابا متشابها. كتابا متشابها مثانية تقشعر منه جلود الذين يخشون ربهم ثم تلين جلودهم وقلوبهم إلى ذكر الله. في سورة الزمر آية 23. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Allah has revealed the best of messages in a form of book consistent with itself. No contradiction in the Quran. Look at it, brothers. The first revelation, اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق. The final ayah of the Quran, وَاتَّقُوا يَوْمًا تُرْجَعُونَ فِيهِ إِلَى اللَّهِ سورة البقرة 281. Between this, 23 years of revelation, brothers and sisters. 23 years of revelation. If it would have been authored by a mankind who was an illiterate at the time, imagine when someone authors a book that takes 23 years, no doubt the beginning of the book and the ending of the book will never be equal. Because you're going to increase, you're going to have more experience, your language is going to get better, you will have a lot of editing into it. But look at the Quran, how beautiful it is in the beginning. اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق. خلق الإنسان من علق. اقرأ وربك الأكرم الذي علم بالقلم علم الإنسان ما لم يعلم. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught our beloved messenger, وعلمك ما لم تكن تعلم. He taught you what you need, what you need not. So when you look at the Quran, brothers and sisters in Islam, there's no contradiction in it. Over 1400 years, no one can ever find a single mistake in the Quran. The form of language that we communicate with one another is either prose or poetry. The Quran is neither of them. Look how beautiful it is. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah An-Nisa, ayah 82, وَلَوْ كَانَ مِنْ عِنْدِ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ لَوَجَدُوا فِيهِ اخْتِلَافًا كَثِيرًا. Had it been from anyone other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will surely find much contradiction in it. No contradiction in the Quran. Look at the Quran. When someone writes, authors a book, always be worried about potential mistakes. My dissertation was 706 pages. But if you look, in the beginning of, I have to make excuses. If you come across any mistakes, you could correct it. But look in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Baqarah, second ayah, Alif Lam Mim, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابِ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ. There's no doubt in it. Quran, there's no doubt in it. Likewise in Surah Al-Sajda, in the beginning of Alif Lam Mim, تَنْزِيلُ الْكِتَابِ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ مِنْ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. There's no doubt that this Quran is from the Lord of the world. So there is no contradiction in the Quran. So when Quraysh and those who came after them tried to challenge the Quran and say this Quran was fabricated, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, first of all, there's no contradiction in it. Secondly, if you can bring something like the Quran, just bring it. Allah is challenging the entire world from the first day of this Quran to the last day of this world. If anyone, not only one, the entire humanity can get together to produce something like the Quran, let them do it. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah At-Tur, ayah 33 and 34, أَمْ يَقُولُونَ تَقَوَّلَهُ بَلْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ فَلْيَأْتُوا بِحَدِيثٍ مِثْلِهِ إِنْ كَانُوا صَادِقِينَ. Are they saying he made it up? He fabricated it? Okay. Let them bring hadith, stories, a message like this Quran if they can. In Surah Isra, ayah 88, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قُلْ لَيْنِ اجْتَمَعَتِ الْإِنسُ وَالْجِنُّ عَلَىٰ أَيَّاتُوا بِمِثْلِ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ لَا يَأْتُونَ بِمِثْلِهِ وَلَوْ كَانَ بَعْضُهُمْ لِبَعْضٍ ظَهِرًا. If a mankind and jinn, we all got together from the first day to the last day, sit together, actually sit with one another to produce the like of the Qur'an, they will never be able to bring it if they all help and assist one another. Allah is challenging us, ikhwani. If there's any fault in the Quran, bring it. Word for word, there's no mistake. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us. There were so many enemies of the Quran of today, they never were able to bring something like the Quran. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lowered the challenge for us. He said, if you cannot bring the entire Quran, which you will never be able to do that, just try to bring 10 chapters like the Quran. In Surah Hud, ayah 13 and 14, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَمْ يَقُولُ نَفْتَرَهُ قُلْ فَأْتُوا بِعَشْرِ سُوَرٍ مِثْلِهِ مُفْتَرَيَاتٍ. Are they saying Muhammad fabricated this Quran? Let them bring 10 chapters like the Quran, fabricated like the Quran. So this is the claim, right? The Quran is fabricated. Just bring 10 chapters like the Quran. You make it up, produce it. وَدْعُوا مَنِ اسْتَطَعْتُمْ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ. And call upon anyone besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if you're telling the truth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then said, فَإِنْ لَمْ يَسْتَجِيبُوا لَكُمْ فَعْلَمُوا أَنَّمَا أُنزِلَ بِعِلْمِ اللَّهِ. If they could not meet this challenge, know that it's indeed from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's revealed with the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there's no deity worthy of worship but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَهَلْتُمْ أَفَلْأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. Are you gonna submit yourself to your Lord? Are you gonna become Muslims? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is challenging us. 10 ayahs like the Quran. Subhanallah, Latifah, if you look at this surah, Surah Hud, is the 11th chapter from the Quran. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this 11th chapter mentioned, bring 10 chapters like the Quran. Subhanallah. No one was able to bring 10 chapters like the Quran. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lowered it down to one chapter. Bring one chapter like the Quran. If it's fabricated, bring one Quran, one chapter like the Quran. One surah, even if it's Surah Al-Kawthar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَمْ يَقُولُونَ افْتَرَاهُ قُلْ فَأْتُوا بِسُورَةٍ مِثْلِهِ وَدْعُوا مَنِ اسْتَطَعْتُمْ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ إِنْ كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. Bring one chapter like the Quran. This is Surah Yunus, ayah 38. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, بَلْ كَذَّبُوا بِمَا لَمْ يُحِيطُوا بِعِلْمِهِ. They just denied something that they did not
have comprehensive knowledge of. ولما يأتيهم تأويله كذلك كذب الذين من قبلهم فانظر كيف كان عاقبة الظالمين ومنهم من يؤمن به ومنهم من لا يؤمن به وربك أعلم بالمفسدين. Then we go back to Surah Al-Baqarah. Also the same thing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Ayah 23 in Surah Al-Baqarah, وَإِنْ كُنْتُمْ فِي رَيْبٍ مِمَّا نَزَّلْنَا عَلَىٰ عَبْدِنَا فَأْتُوا بِسُورَةٍ مِثْلِهِ. Bring one surah like the Quran. وَادْعُوا مَنِ اسْتَطَعْتُمْ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ إِنْ كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. Call upon everyone besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if you're telling the truth. فَإِنْ لَمْ تَفْعَلُوا, if you're not able to do it, وَلَنْ تَفْعَلُوا, and you will never be able to do it. That's why some scholars like Zamakhshari, they say لَنْ in لغة العربية تفيد تأبيد النفي. That means when we say لَنْ, you can't. But realistically, we don't benefit this from the لَنْ itself in لغة العربية. Imam Malik, Ibn Malik رحمه الله say في كتابه في ألفيته, وَمَنْ يَرَى النفي بلن مؤبدا فقوله هردد وسواه فعضدا. This is just out of the topic. So basically, ikhwani, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is challenging every mankind in this earth to produce something like this Quran, 10 chapters like the Quran, and even one chapter like Quran. The entire world failed. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Inna nahnu nazzalna dhikra wa inna lahu lahafidhun. Allah said, we are the one who revealed the Quran and will surely protect the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserved the Quran, brothers and sisters. And no one can tell the truth as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has spoken the truth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah An-Nisa, Ayah 87, وَمَنْ أَزْدَقُ مِنَ اللَّهِ حَدِيثًا. Ayah 122 in Surah An-Nisa, وَمَنْ أَزْدَقُ مِنَ اللَّهِ قِيلًا. Who is more truthful than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his speech? Who is more truthful than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in utterance? No one, brothers and sisters. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala command every believer to say sadaqallah in Surah Al Imran, ayah 95, قُلْ صَدَقَ اللَّهِ. Say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has spoken the truth. Repeat after me in your mind, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has spoken the truth. Brothers and sisters in Islam, this Quran is a blessed book. So many ayat in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, this is the blessed book. If we're seeking for blessing in this life and in the hereafter, we just need to seek through the Quran, ikhwan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah As-Sad, ayat 29, كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ إِلَيْكَ مُبَارَكٌ لِيَدَّبَّرُوا آيَاتِهِ. كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ إِلَيْكَ مُبَارَكٌ. A blessed book that we revealed upon you. Surah An'am, ayat 92, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَهَذَا كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ مُبَارَكٌ مصدق لما بين يديه. Also in Surah Al-An'am, ayah 155, وَهَذَا كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ مُبَارَكٌ فَاتَّبِعُوا. So if you want to seek blessings through the Quran, brothers and sisters in Islam, then we just need to follow it. وَهَذَا كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ مُبَارَكٌ فَاتَّبِعُوهُ وَاتَّقُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. If you want to find any blessing in this life, if you want to find any mercy in this life, then we should follow the Quran step by step. This is how we find and how we gain blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Through the reflection of the Quran also, brothers, we need to learn the Quran, we need to understand the Quran. The mushkila that we have, especially in the Somali community, we memorize the Quran. We actually force our kids to memorize the Quran. But do they really understand? It's not different for them, a book like Chinese they're reading, because they don't understand it. We definitely need to change the manhaj that we teach our kids, brothers. We cannot have the kids memorize the Quran when they don't understand it. When we parents fail to understand and fail to memorize the Quran, how do we expect from our kids to memorize and understand the Quran? Parents need to understand this. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ إِلَيْكَ مُبَارَكٌ لِيَدَّبَّرُوا آيَاتِهِ. So that they reflect upon the verse of the Quran. How do you reflect and ponder about the Quran when you don't understand it? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قُلْ انظُرُوا مَاذَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. قُلْ انظُرُوا مَاذَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Observe, look, what's in the heavens and in the earth. وَمَا تُغْنِي الْآيَاتُ وَالنُّذُرُ عَنْ قَوْمٍ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. It's not going to benefit those who believe, does not believe in akhirah. وَكَأَيِّ مِنْ آيَاتٍ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ يَمُرُّونَ عَلَيْهَا وَهُمْ عَنْهَا مُعْرِضُونَ. How many ayat, verses and signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do they encounter on a daily basis while they turn away from it? Surah Yusuf 105. So the most important thing is, brothers and sisters, to reflect upon the Quran. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah
المؤمنون آية 68 أفلم يدبروا القول. سورة النساء آية 82 أم جاء أم على قلوب أقفالها أفلا يتدبرون القرآن. في سورة الأنفال في سورة النساء 82 أفلا يتدبرون القرآن. في سورة محمد آية 24 أفلا يتدبرون القرآن أم على قلوب أقفالها or their hearts have been sealed. How are we going to ponder and reflect upon the Quran when we don't understand the Quran, brothers and sisters? Quran is a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Quran is a guidance for us in this life. Quran is light which we will be guided based through this life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَنْ لَمْ يَجْعَلِ اللَّهُ لَهُ نُورًا فَمَا لَهُ مِنْ نُورًا. Whomever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not give light, doesn't have any light. The light is the Quran. Quran is a life. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Anfal, ayah 24, استجيبوا لله وللرسول إذا دعاكم لما يحييكم. Respond to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger when they call you to that which gives you life. لما يحييكم. Life. Quran gives us life. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah An'am, ayah 122, أَوَمَنْ كَانَ مَيْتًا فَأَحْيَيْنَاهُ وَجَعَلْنَا لَهُ نُورًا يَمْشِي بِهِ فِي النَّاسِ كَمَنْ مَثَلُهُ فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ لَيْسَ بِخَارِجٍ مِنْهَا. إخواني, how do we attain the light and the guidance of the Quran? How do we attain the blessings of the Quran when we neglect the Quran? We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the understanding of His book. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the ability to overcome our desires. فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. الحمد لله على إحساني. الشكر له على توفيقه وامتنانه. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي الصالحين وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وسلم كثيرا كبيرا تسليما كثيرا كبيرا. My brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إخواني, has revealed this Quran for the purpose of this life and the hereafter. When you look at the life of our beloved Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his Sahaba, those who were surrounding him, and you compare the life of Sahaba to our life, you see how opposite to one another it is. Look at the life of Sahaba when the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was revealed. They were nomads, brothers and sisters. They were illiterate. They could not read or write. Great majority of the Sahaba, when they accepted Islam, they could not read and write. And I bet you everyone in this gathering can at least read and write. Yet, when they hold fast on the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah raised their status in this life and in the hereafter. But when we neglected and turned away from the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then this is how we ended up in our life, brothers and sisters. Look at our life. If we believe this Quran to be truly from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then why hesitate? There shouldn't be any doubt that this book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most authentic and the most beautiful message on this earth. Imagine if we have manual guide and you don't understand the language of it and you don't want to act of it. If you have a bylaws in your organization or in your business and then you don't know the bylaws and you don't understand it, how are you going to succeed in your life, brothers and sisters in Islam? We need to change our life, brothers and sisters in Islam. Quran is a barakah for us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us, called us to Jannah. Wallahu yad'u ila dar salam. And you will never attain Jannah, brothers and sisters in Islam, except through the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the sunnah of His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded our beloved Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to hold fast into the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَاسْتَمْسِكْ بِالَّذِي أُوحِيَ إِلَيْكَ إِنَّكَ عَلَى صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ وَإِنَّهُ لَذِكْرٌ لَكَ وَلِقَوْمِكَ وَسَوْفَ تُسْأَلُونَ. 43 and 44 in Surah Az-Zukhruf. فَاسْتَمْسِكْ, hold fast into that which we have revealed upon you. Indeed, you are upon a straight path. وَإِنَّهُ لَذِكْرُ لَكَ, surely is a reminder for you and for your people. وَسَوْفَ تُسْأَلُونَ, and you will be questioned in the day of judgment. فَلَنَسْأَلَنَّ الَّذِينَ أُرْسِلَ إِلَيْهُمْ وَلَنَسْأَلَنَّ الْمُرْسَلِينَ. Brothers and sisters in Islam, I advise myself and you to make this year the year of the Quran. 2016 should be the year of the Quran of the believers in the entire world. Let us change our life. Let us look back to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's a guidance for us. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Isra, ayah number 9, إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ
Surely this book, يَهْدِي لِلَّتِي هِيَ أَقْوَمُ, guides to that which is the most upright. We need to go back to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we need anything, we find in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I could continue and go on and on and on. But the most important thing, how can we change our life from today? How can we simply reconnect with the Quran? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to communicate with us through the Quran. Let us try to change our life, even if we can start reading the Quran today, from today. Even one single ayah on a daily basis. If we can try to understand one ayah in the entire week, if we can't even try to understand one ayah in the entire month. Brothers and sisters in Islam, we know we have masahif in our offices, in our cars, in our homes, but that will not benefit us, brothers and sisters in Islam. We need to change our life. This is the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you want to attain and gain success in this life and in the hereafter, we need to change our life. Simply by reading the Quran, reflecting upon the Quran through learning it. We may be 40, 60 years Muslims, but we may not even know the meaning of one juz. We may not even know the meaning of one surah. And we may expect from our kids who were born in America to memorize the Quran. It's impossible, ikhwan. We need to make them understand. We need to change our life. Allahumma arina al-haqqa haqqan warzuqna tiba'a. Wal-batila batila warzuqna jtinaba. اللهم اهدنا لما اختلف فيه من الحق بإذنك إنك تهدي من تشاء إلى صراط مستقيم. اللهم يا سامع الصوت ويا سابق الفوت ويا كاسي العظام لحما بعد الموت, صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد, ولا تدع لنا في يومنا هذا ذنبا إلا غفرته, ولا هما إلا فرجته, ولا دينا إلا قضيته, ولا مريضا إلا عافيته, ولا ضالا إلا هديته, ولا باغيا إلا قطعته, ولا عدوا إلا خذلته, ولا عسيرا إلا يسرته, ولا ميتا إلا رحمته, برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. وأقم الصلاة إن الصلاة كانت على المؤمنين كتابا موقوتا.